but the language of the evidence speaks of the strip in question as found around the neck, fitting loosely, and secured with a hard knot. These words are sufficiently vague, but differ materially from those of Le Commerciel. The slip was 18 inches wide, and therefore, although of muslin, would form a strong band when folded or rumpled longitudinally. And thus rumpled it was discovered. My inference is this. The solitary murderer, having borne the corpse for some distance, whether from the thicket or elsewhere, by means of the bandage hitched around its middle, found the weight, in this mode of procedure, too much for his strength. He resolved to drag the burthen. The evidence goes to show that it was dragged. With this object in view, it became necessary to attach something like a rope to one of the extremities. It could best be attached about the neck, where the head would prevent it slipping off. And now, the murderer bethought him, unquestionably, of the bandage about the loins. He would have used this, but for its volition about the corpse, the hitch which embarrassed it, and the reflection that it had not been torn off from the garment. It was easier to tear a new slip from the petticoat. He tore it, made it fast about the neck, and so dragged his victim to the brink of the river. That this bandage, only attainable with trouble and delay, and all but imperfectly answering its purpose, that this bandage was employed at all, demonstrates that the necessity for its employment sprang from circumstances arising at the period when the handkerchief was no longer attainable. That is to say, arising, as we have imagined, after quitting the thicket, if the thicket it was, and on the road between the thicket and the river.